Welcome to Nithyavin Padivigal. In this video, we are going to discuss problems from exercise 2.3. In this exercise, we have 5 questions from Class 6 CBSE Max. Let us see the problems and their solutions. Problem number 1 and its solution. Which of the following will not represent 0? So, we are given 4 options. We have to evaluate all the 4 options and we have to find out which is not equal to 0. Okay. So, this is an expression with 2 terms, 1 and 0. Here we have sum. Here we have multiplication. Here we have division. Here we have difference and division. So, which expression will not represent 0? So, which is not equal to 0? That is the question here. Let us do one by one. 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. Because 0 plus any number is equal to the number itself. So, 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. So, we can conclude that this expression will not represent 0. Let us consider the remaining options also for our verification. 0 multiplied by 0. 0 multiplied by any number is 0. So 0 into 0 is equal to 0 only. C. 0 divided by 2 is equal to what? 0 divided by 2 is equal to 0 only because 2 into 0 only can give you 0 as the result. Right. In second multiplication table, 0 times 2 or 2 times 0 only will give you 0 as the product. Okay. The result of multiplying 2 and 0 only can give you 0 as the result. So 0 by 2 is equal to 0. If you have anything in your, if you have nothing in your hand, then how can you divide it into 2 equal parts? Just imagine, you have 0 chocolates, either no chocolates in your hand, but you have to distribute no chocolates to 2 children. Then how many chocolates will be given to each children? Nothing, right? So, 0 divided by 2 is equal to 0 only. Then, the last option is 10 minus 10 whole divided by. You should read this like whole divided by, which means whatever are said earlier, they all will be covered by this divided by 2. Okay. 10 minus 10 divided by 2 is by this divided by 2. Okay, 10 minus 10 divided by 2 is not correct. 10 minus 10 whole divided by 2 is correct, which is equal to, let us do the numerator part first. 10 minus 10 is 0 divided by 2. So again, 0 divided by 2 is equal to 0. We have the reason here. So option A is only representing 0. Options B, C, D are representing 0. Option A is not representing 0. Second problem and its solution. If the product of 2 whole numbers is 0, can we say that one or both of them will be 0? If the product of 2 whole numbers is 0, see, we have the hint whole numbers. So we can choose 0 also as the one of the products. Okay. Justify through examples. So you have to prove your answer with examples. Okay. Before going into the problem, just let us recall, whole numbers is denoted by W and is equal to set of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Natural numbers along with 0 are called whole numbers. Okay. What we have to find product of two whole numbers we have to find. We have three cases. At least one number is 0, both the numbers are 0, no number is 0, both the numbers are other than 0, right? So we have three cases here. In case 1 and case 2, we have 0. See, 0 multiplied by any number is 0. So we have 0 while having 0 as one of the products. In case 2, we have two zeros. Both the numbers are 0, which means 0 into 0 is equal to 0. Third case, both the numbers are not 0. So you can choose the numbers for your convenience. That's why I have chosen here very small number. 1 into 2 is equal to 2. 3 into 4 or 4 into 3 is equal to 12. See, in your product, if you have any one of the numbers is equal to 0, then you get the result as 0. In your product or multiplication, if both the numbers are not 0, then the result will not be equal to 0. From the above three cases, we can conclude that no need to panic to write the sentences. The sentence is there in question itself. See, if, remove the question word, if. What is the conclusion? The product of two whole numbers is 0, then we can say that one or both of them will be 0, right? That is what I have written here. Always don't forget to write written here. Always don't forget to write the word statements. Okay? Don't think, do I need to write the statements? Yes, of course. Definitely you have to write the word statements. The statements will be mostly from question itself. So you will get the techniques, tips from the question itself. Okay? It is always convenient for you to write the word statements from question. Problem number 3. If the product of two whole numbers is 1, then can we say that one or both of them will be 1? Justify through examples. Here also, let us see some examples. So product of two whole numbers is 1. So here whole numbers is given. So we can choose 0 also, but product is 1. Product of two whole numbers is 1 means we cannot choose 0 as one of the two whole numbers. Because while multiplying any number by 0, you will get 0 only. You will never get 1. So what are the situations other than choosing 0 in your product? 1 time 1, 1 time 2, 1 time 3, and so on. Right? In all these cases, 1 time 1 only gives you 1 as the result. 1 time 2, 1 time 3, 1 time 4, 1 time any number will give you the same number itself. So this is the only case in which we are getting the product of two whole numbers is 1. Okay? The only factor of 1 is 1 itself. So from the above examples, we can conclude that the product of two whole numbers is 1. Then we can say that one, not one of them, both of them will be 1. Okay? That is highlighted here. If the product of two whole numbers is 1, then the product of two whole numbers is 1 only if both of them will be 1. So this is the conclusion. Keep practicing. Problem number 4, and it's a subdivisions. We have 5 subdivisions here. This is the problem using distributive property. Subdivision A, 728 multiplied by 101. So distributive of multiplication over addition. So that is what we have learnt earlier, right? So let us recall the property first. Distributive property. What is a distributive property? We may have problems in the form of A times B plus C. A multiplied in the form of A times B plus C. A multiplied by B plus C. This is not like A multiplied B plus C. Not like that. You have to read this expression as A multiplied by B plus C, which means A should be multiplied by B and also by C. So this expression is equal to A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. See, A multiplied by B, then we have the plus operator here. So plus A multiplied by C. Okay, let us have some example, simple example. 1 is multiplied by 2 plus 3. See, I am giving you 2 chocolates and 3 candies. Okay. So, how many times? One time only I am giving you. So, totally how many chocolates and candies are given? 1 time 2, which means 2 chocolates, plus 1 time 3, 3 candies are given. Or else, you can create your own situations. 2 pencils are given first and then 3 more pencils are given the second time. So, 1 time you are given 2 plus 3 chocolate, 3 pencils is equal to giving 2 pencils one time plus giving 3 pencils one time. So, this is called a distributive property. Okay. So, 1 time 2 plus 3 is equal to 1 time 2 plus 1 time 3. So, very easy rule. You have to keep this in your mind. So, we have to write the given expression like A into B plus C. In this form, we have to write the given expression. You can split either 728 or 101. In case of you are splitting 728, you have to do this like 700 plus 20 plus 8 multiplied by 101. Instead of that, splitting 101 as 100 plus 1 will be easy for you. See, which is equal to 728 multiplied by 101 is equal to 728 multiplied by 100 plus 1. Here, this is of the form A into B plus C. Here, A is equal to 728, B is equal to 100, and C is equal to 1. So, A into B plus C is equal to A into B, 728 multiplied by 100, plus A into C, which means 728 multiplied by 1. See, we have 2 zeros in the end. So, put 2 zeros. Then, 728 multiplied by 1 is 728. We have 728 as the product of, as a result of first product, plus 728 multiplied by 1 is 728. Adding these two numbers, ones with ones, tens with tens, 0 with 2. Adding these two numbers, ones with ones, tens with tens, 0 with 2. Hundreds with hundreds, 8 with 7. Adding these numbers, we get 73,528 as the result. See, 1 is the number which is carried over. So, 72800 plus 728 gives you 73528. Instead of multiplying directly 728 by 101, we have split the number for our convenience and we have done with the correct answer. Okay? So, this is the easiest way for using distributive property. In the same way, we are doing the second problem, second subdivision B. 5437 multiplied by 1001, which is equal to 5437 multiplied by, it is easy to split, it is easy to write 1001 as a sum of two numbers. We get 1000 plus 1. So this is of the form A into B plus C. Here A is 5437, B is 1000, C is 1. So, which is equal to, it is written in the form of A into B plus A into C. Now, the first product is giving you 5437 with 3 zeros plus the second product is 5437 multiplied by 1, which gives you 5437. Adding this, we get 5442437. Addition is done here. We are adding directly. No need to write again in rough work. You are grown up. You are in class 6. So, hereafter, you should do mind calculation only. 0 with 7, 7. 0 plus 3, 3. 0 plus 4, 4. Then 7 plus 5 is 12. 2 is written. 1 is carried over in 10,000 place. So, 1 plus 3 is 4. 4. Next, we don't have any number in 10,000 place and lakh place. So, 5, 4 are written directly down. Written down. So 5442437 is the answer for the given question. Okay. Similarly, we are going to do the same. We are going to do the problems. 824 multiplied by 25. This can be written as 20 plus 5 also. 824 multiplied by 20 plus 5 also you can do. Okay. Here I have written 824 as 800 plus 24. Okay, multiplied by 25. This is of the form A into B plus C. A multiplied by B plus C. Because you may ask me, this is of the form A plus B multiplied by C. Yeah, you can say that way also. But 2 into 3 is equal to 3 into 2, right? That commutator. Here, I have written 824 as 800 plus 24, okay, multiplied by 25. This is of the form A into B plus C. A multiplied by B plus C. Because you may ask me, this is of the form A plus B multiplied by C. Yeah, you can say that way also. But 2 into 3 is equal to 3 into 2, right? That commutative property, we are calling it as commutative property. So, 25, this expression can be read as 25 multiplied by 800 plus 24 also. So, both are same only. So, we can apply the distributive property like 800 multiplied by 25 plus 24 multiplied by 25. But, still we are splitting up number 24. How? 800 plus 24 is written as 25 minus 1. So, we are extending the distributive property. Now, what to do? Multiply 800 with 25 plus 25 with 25 and 1 with 25. So, we are multiplying each and every number by 25. See, now our work is very easy. It has become more convenient. Two zeros in the end. So, put two zeros. 8 multiplied by 25. The calculation is done here. First, 8 with the ones. 8 multiplied by 5 is 40. 0 is written here. The third zero from the right is written here. 4 is carried over. Now 8 multiplied by 2 is 16 plus 4 is 20. So 20000. The first product is over. Plus 25 multiplied by 25. The calculation is done here, which is equal to 625. Minus 1 times 25 is 25. So 625 minus 25 is 600. Already we have 20,000. So, adding them together gives you 20,600. Calculations are given here in rough workspace. So, the result is 20,600. Okay. 4D. 4275 multiplied by 125. 125. This is the smallest number, so we are writing this as sum of three numbers 100 plus 20 plus 5. This is of the form A into B plus C plus D, which means the extension of distributive property. So 4275 should be multiplied with 100 and also with 20 and also with 5. That is the meaning. 4275 multiplied by 100 is 4275, two zeros. 4275 multiplied by 20, we have 10 here, put 10. Now multiply 4275 by 2. 2 into 5, 10. 1 is carried over. 2 into 7, 14. Plus 1, 5. 1 is carried over. 2 into 2, 4. Plus 1, 5. 2 into 4, 8. So 85500. This is the answer for this product. Next, 4275 multiplied by 5. Calculation is done here. These are the numbers, 132 are the numbers carried over. We have the result as 21375. Adding them together, this is the rough work. You can check yourself. While adding them together, we get the answer 534375. One more method is there. Instead of writing 125 as sum of three numbers, you can choose 4275. To write as sum of three numbers, and that is multiplied by 125. So for your convenience only, you are choosing a number to split. Okay, if you are choosing this way, you have to do the multiplication four times. If you are splitting the three digit number, it is enough to do the multiplication for three times. Okay, so we have chosen this three digit number times. Okay, so we have chosen this three digit number as 100 plus 20 plus 5. In the same way, 4e is done here. Here 504 is three digit number, 35 is two digit number, yet we can write this in a simple way: 500 plus 4. If you have 514, 524 like that, it will be sum of three numbers. But you have 0 in tens place, so it is easy for us to write 504 as 500 plus 4 multiplied by 35. So multiply 35 should be multiplied with 500 and also with 4. 500 into 35 plus 4 into 35. So you get the answers as 17500. 2 is the number carried over on multiplying 5 with 35, plus 4 into 35 is equal to 140, and adding these two, you get the answer 17640. So 504 multiplied by 35 is equal to 17640. Method 2. Here you can split 35 as 30 plus 5. So 504 is multiplied by 30 plus 504 multiplied by 5. So in this case also, you are getting the answer 17640. So there is no compulsion that you should choose the first number only to split or the second number only to split. It is purely up to you. For your convenience, you can split any number. Okay. Problem number 5. Study the pattern 1 times 8 plus 1, which is equal to 9. 1, 2 multiplied by 8 plus 2 is equal to 9, 8. 1, 2, 3 multiplied by 8 plus 3 is equal to 9, 8, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4 multiplied by 8 plus 4 is equal to 9, 8, 7, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 multiplied by 8 plus 5 is equal to 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Write the next two steps. Can you say how the pattern works? So we have to write the next two steps, and then we have to say how does the pattern work. Okay. One hint is given. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 can be written as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, a 5 digit number with 1 in all the 5 places, plus a 4-digit number with 1 in all the 4 places plus 111 plus 111 sorry 11 plus 1. So let us check whether this sum is equal to 12345. See, here I have done the rough work. So adding them together, we get 12345. Right. So this pattern, we have to check whether this pattern is working out for our answer. To justify our answer. Before that, on seeing this pattern, in each and every step, in the first number, each number is increased by 1 digit. And the first one starts with 1, and the second number is having 2 digit, 1 is followed by 2. Here, 1 and 2 are followed by 3. Here, 1, 2, 3 are followed by 4. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4 is followed by 5. So, next step, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is already there. Write the 5-digit number. And then, this is the 6th step. So, add one more digit, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then, multiplied by 8 is there in all the steps. So, write multiplied by 8 plus 6th step. So, 6 is to be added, which is equal to, without doing actual multiplication, on seeing this pattern itself, you can write the answer. How? See, in each and every answer, first digit is 9. Write 9. And in each and every step, the answer is getting increased by 1 digit. And the answer is in decreasing order, starting from 9. So, in that pattern, let us write the answer. The last answer is 98765. Write this 98765. And then, while moving on with the decreasing order, 4 is the next number. So, write 4. 987654. That's all. Okay. This is the next step. But we have to write next 2 steps. So, 6th step we have written. 7th step. 7th step means 7th step will be having 7 digits in this number. So, what are they? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 along with 7. Multiplied by 8 is common plus 7th step. So, 7 is to be added, which is equal to. I am not going to do any multiplication here or any addition here, but I am going to follow the pattern given and I am going to write the answer. How? The previous answer is 9876543. Okay. Now, here, previous is 987654. Here, we are in the 7th step. So, we have to add one more digit. That also will be a number less than 4. So, it's 3. So, 987654 is the answer. We are not yet finished. We have one more step to do. Can you say how the pattern works? Is the pattern working? Let us see. Verification. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have to do the verification for the next 2 steps, which we did. Okay. In our solution. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is 6-digit number with 1 in all places and 5-digit number with 1 in all places plus 4-digit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is 6-digit number with 1 in all places and 5-digit number with 1 in all places plus 4-digit number with 1 in all places plus 3-digit number with 1 in all places plus 2-digit number with 1 in all places and 1. So, now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 multiplied by 8 is sum of all these numbers multiplied by 8. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 multiplied by 8 is 888888. Okay. Don't get confused with these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. These are the numbers carried over while adding. Okay. Now, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 multiplied by 8 is 88888. 1, 1, 1, 1 multiplied by 8 is 8888 plus 1, 1, 1 multiplied by 8 is 888 plus 1, 1 multiplied by 8 is 88 plus 1 multiplied by 8 is 8. Instead of writing plus sign again and again, it is enough to put 1 plus sign here. Now add them together. We have 6 8s here. So 48, 8 is written here, 4 is carried over. We have 5 8s, 40 plus 4 is 44. 4 is written here and 4 in tens place is carried over. Now we have 4 8s. So 4 8s are 32 plus 4 is 36, 6, 3 is carried over. 3 times 8 is 24 plus 3, 27, 2 is carried over, 7 is written here. 2 times 8 is 16 plus 2, 18, 1 is carried over, 1 plus 8 is 9. See, but the answer is not yet over. What is the complete expression? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 multiplied by 8 plus 6 is there. We have done this product only. We have to add the result with 6. See, 9, 8, 7, 6, 4, 8 plus 6 is, see, 48 plus 6 is 54. All other digits are remaining same. So 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4 is the answer. Therefore, the pattern works here. This way we have to complete the verification. This verification should be written because we are asked to evaluate, we are asked to justify our answer whether the pattern works or not. Similarly, we have to do the next step also. Okay, I have given the same steps, same kind of steps. You can do yourself. You can check the steps and the answer yourself. It is left to you. Keep practicing. Thank you for watching. For more maths videos, subscribe and press the bell button for Nithyavin Padivegal YouTube channel. Thank you.